20 years ago, other photographers were like, why can't we shoot for Vogue, or why can't we do this back in, you know, the 90s? And there were some great photographers, and a lot of people got discouraged. And that's the hardest thing, is not being discouraged as an artist. When I first discovered photography, Gordon was one of the first photographers that I found out about. And it was his story following gangs in Harlem. And it was this eerie shot of the leader of the gang, you know, staring out the window, you know, and just him following that gang through Harlem, going to funerals. Things that I see in my day-to-day life really touched me to let me know that I could document those moments too. My community in Baltimore, we never really get to speak for ourselves. It's usually like a external voice that's always speaking for us. And, you know, and I think that's the issue with a lot of Black communities similar to mine, where that external voice is louder than the internal voice. They talk about The Wire, they talk about, you know, the murder rate, you know, they talk about the fact that we was the heroin capital of America at one point in time. But it's intimate moments that I know growing up in Baltimore that a lot of people don't get to see. So I wanted to make sure that I can counter that narrative, document everything. When I saw what Gordon was able to do in Harlem and tell their story, you know, and not demonize them, those images just screamed to me, you know, really, really, really loud.
For me, the young girls at the chain link fence looking out and seeing the white girls playing. One, it's a beautifully composed image, but also I think I saw that at a relatively young age and I didn't comprehend the impact of it, but I always remembered it because I remember how it made me feel. Because it made me feel like I was an outsider. It made me feel like I was an other. So that initial image was like, oh, this is the power of imagery.
Gordon Parks is a huge influence on all photography, not just African-Americans, Blacks, Hispanics, whatever, white, it's everyone. He's just a huge icon in the photography industry. So when I was growing up, when I was studying photography, he was always someone I was looking up to or just try to emulate or try to just find out how he did something.
When I first like discovered Gordon Parks, just seeing, I guess, those different kinds of applications to street photography in Harlem really pushed me.
The work of Gordon Parks is very instrumental to my growth and development early on. You know, before I even really knew his name, I was just seeing images and what he documented, you know, from Muhammad Ali to Malcolm X to the Nation of Islam to racism in the South.
When I got into photography, I would always study, you know, the Jermell Shabazz, the Gordon Parks, the Tony Barbosas, the Ruddy Roys.
There's so many Black photographers that just their perspective is like I felt like I knew them through the imagery.
You know, I was introduced to the work of James Van Der Zee, and that was very instrumental in developing my eye as a photographer, because now I'm seeing Black pride and dignity. So that kind of like shaped my vision to look for that love, to look for the dignity in my own personal journey. And then there's a number of unknown photographers that really need to be known. Luis Mendez, Howard Cash, Suleiman Ellison. Those are some of the main ones who served almost like my big brothers back in the day.
You know, I'm self-taught and I never really had a lot of photographer friends when I was learning how to be a photographer. And I didn't really think that there were that many Black photographers out there, because at the time, like, I was only seeing white photographers being successful in the space. And then I started meeting people like Giancarlo Valentine. I honestly feel like he's like one of the Gordon Parks of our time, like really, really beautiful, impactful work. And like, I love Kennedy Carter's work. And I just feel like there's so many important people that are here now and that you can actually, you know, see making headway in the industry and making headway in history, and that we just have never had before, you know?
Yeah. Truly, yeah. So many incredible people who are making work that will stand the test of time.
Yeah.
I think it's okay for us to say that we are living with the legends.
Yeah. Just sitting on the table with you guys, I've had to pinch myself a couple of times because your cover of Megan Thee Stallion is just like, man, no. Like,
I only have 5 minutes to shoot literally. That.
Power. And I'm sitting right next to the gentleman.
You know, sitting next to Kwaku, for coming up, you were honestly, as far as an accomplished Black photographer whose name we were seeing on a regular basis, like, we were looking for the bylines, we were trying to find, and it was that name. It was like, you know, the Oprah dinner, and it was like, who's shooting this? Who did she get to capture this? And then it's like, the Obamas, it's just, you know, I think what Eric said and what Dana's saying, like, the ones that we look up to are really here, and I mean, I need you to understand that.
Thank you. I mean, I stand on the shoulders of so many people, so many photographers. It's a journey, and I'm just happy to be doing it and helping my friends and helping people come up with me. And it really is a community thing. It really is a fellowship. We have to do it together.
A lot of Black photographers were taken advantage of in 2020 after George Floyd died.
Oh, yeah.
They would swindle out of their work because they did not understand leasing agreements and the agreements that they were signing. They just wanted to get the work out there.
Yeah.
And these editors need to be held accountable because they knew what they were doing.
I think that this happens way too often with younger photographers or photographers that just don't know any better because you're just like, oh, I'm just happy to be here and I'm not going to know that I need to be able to license this work in the future that these are prints for my future, you know, like gallery shows for a museum exhibition. And like, this is how white photographers eat into their 60s, 70s, 80s, because they can license those images. They can have, you know, retrospectives. And it's like, now you don't own anything. And so many young photographers don't own most of their work. And they don't realize it.
You know, Gordon has this thing where he said that the camera is a weapon. And I didn't really understand that until Mike Brown died and Ferguson erupted. You know, I had this camera in my hand. You know, Gordon said it's a weapon. You know, so I went down to the protest. And for once, I really understood how powerful my imagery was. My work is sitting in the Gordon Parks archive. You know, like when people say, you know, sky's the limit and dreams come true, I'm literally walking in my own truth right now because I was so adamant about taking pictures and wanted to chase this outlandish dream that people told me that would never happen. But now, you know, I stand here and it's happening.
Gordon Parks didn't just pave the way. He built the road, brick by brick. And we love him for that. We honor and thank him for that. His work gave courage to others to lock in on the barriers that could and would be broken down.
Well, who here at the table was self-taught?
Well, I guess I was, kind of.
I just remember sitting outside on the street one day around the way telling my friends, I think I want to be a photographer. And like, everybody bust out laughing, you know, because we didn't know any artists or any photographers. They said, you got to go to art school or something for that. And I was like, well, if my homegirls can, you know, learn how to do makeup and lace front wigs from YouTube, I think I can learn photography.
And when we shot School Days, the first week, I was trying to develop my own film in the bathroom in the hotel. I didn't know that there's a studio that you could send the film to that they would process. I thought I had to do everything myself. That's how green I was.
But guess who's getting booked and paid to come talk to you? Right. A self-taught photographer. I'm coming to your school and speaking now.
I'm going to have to, I partially agree, but I have to disagree.